The biggest scandal was when they spied on my campaign. They spied on my campaign.
There's no real evidence of that.
Of course there is.
No.
It's all over the place. Leslie,
sir,
they spied on my campaign and they got caught.
Can I say something? You know, this is 60 Minutes, and we can't put on things we can't verify.
You won't put it on because it's bad for Biden.
We can't things we can't verify.
Leslie, they spied on my campaign.
Well, we can't verify
it. It's been totally verified.
No.
It's been, just go down and get the papers. They spied on my campaign, they got caught.
No.
And then they went much further than that, and they got caught. And you will see that, Leslie. And you know that, but you just don't want to put it on the air.
As a matter of fact, I don't know that.
How's everybody doing? My name is Anthony Brian Logan, and today we got to talk about evidence that points toward paid Hillary Clinton operatives spying on Trump during the 2016 presidential election at Trump Tower, at his private high-rise luxury apartment building, and also when he became the president inside the actual White House itself, in the Oval Office. Now, there's so much to get through here. I'm not really sure where to begin, but first things first, I think that Trump has been vindicated 100% because remember, when Trump was out there talking about, well, I've been spied on, I had my wires tapped, all this, that, and the third from Clinton, Obama, etc. What did the mainstream media say? What did the politicians say? Those that were in power, even someone on the right, oh, this is ridiculous conspiracy theories and you don't have any evidence and how dare you make that claim, all this, that, and the third. It's similar to what the reaction was to his allegations of election tampering in 2020. Oh, this is ridiculous. You can't say that this election was fair and free and there was no fraud. Fraud never happens, all this, that, and the third. But when you're talking about the other side, when you're talking about Hillary Clinton, you can say things like that and it's not really your problem, right? Because Hillary is still to this day in 2022 talking about how the election was stolen from her by the Russians. They interfered, they hacked, they did it, Trump was involved, they colluded, all this and that. Even though there was the special investigation from 2017 to 2019, the Mueller probe, the Russia probe, whatever you want to call it, that found that there was no collusion between Trump and the Russians. Sure, they said the Russians favored Trump over Hillary, like I did as well, but that doesn't mean that Trump talked to Vladimir Putin on the phone talking about, hey, man, can you hack the DNC? Can you hack X, Y, and Z people? Help me out. None of that happened at all. Okay. So that was nothing, Berger. It was nothing there. But Hillary Clinton still maintains that it happened. Why? Well, Hillary Clinton and the rest of the establishment, quite frankly, were really invested in the whole Russia angle working for a variety of reasons. Let's talk about Jake Sullivan. Now, Jake Sullivan was Hillary Clinton's foreign policy advisor, and he's the current national security advisor to Joe Biden. Jake Sullivan was the guy talking about, oh, Russia, they did it. They're the ones that were involved with it. We have evidence right here. And then a lot of that fear-mongering and talks and whatnot is what started the Russia probe back in 2017, okay? But Jake Sullivan was one of the main guys talking about Russia, Russia, Russia. Now, he's back at it again, trying to get into a war with Russia or a proxy war in Ukraine to force NATO to come into the region for their own purposes that don't really benefit the U.S. of A. Okay, you follow where I'm going? Now, Jake Sullivan was saying that the Russians were involved with the 2016 presidential election, and he cited this article that came from Slate. Now, in the Slate article, they were talking about a group of computer scientists were able to discover like some kind of secret server in Trump Tower or somewhere that was being used to communicate with the Russians directly. Okay. Now, the problem is that this so-called group of scientists, computer scientists, they were actually some oppo guys. You know, they were doing opposition research on behalf of this guy by the name of Jaffe. I forget his first name. But it's Rodney Jaffe, South African. What he did was hire a bunch of guys, mostly from Georgia Tech, to basically spy on Trump. And the reason why he did that is because he was trying to get a job with Hillary Clinton in the administration, and she was going to win. He's a Hillary Clinton supporter. He wanted her to win, and he was trying to get a job. So he is morally motivated and also financially motivated to make this whole thing work. So any kind of data, quote unquote, that they collected was then passed off to the federal allies, passed off to the FBI. Now we have the whole Russia collusion thing. Now we have the Russia probe. And now we have the Durham probe to figure out where all this stuff came from. And in the Durham probe, just recently, there was a court filing that said all this stuff, talking about Rodney Jaffe and the computer scientists, probably Jake Sullivan and what he was doing and what he said, all this, that, and the third. Okay, that's how we figured out that they were spying on Trump in the Oval Office, in Trump Tower, and also at his private residence in the high-rise luxury apartment building. Now, I'm not sure if the Trump Tower spying was in addition to what we know about already, which was the Carter Page spying, because remember, quote unquote, they said that Carter Page had links to Russia, so they authorized a FISA warrant to spy on Carter Page. But Carter Page is in the Trump campaign, so if Carter Page is in Trump Tower, they're spying on Trump Tower. They're spying on the whole thing. Whatever they get that's quote unquote incidentally collected, they may be able to use. You see what I'm saying? Although they did all that, they still found nothing. The Russia probe found nothing. Not at all. Big fat goose egg. They were trying to get him on whatever they could, but they can't. And here we are talking about it today in 2022. Now, as far as the White House, they didn't find anything there. But when you heard about certain leaks happening from the White House, you're asking, why, you know, what's going on with all these leaks? What's happening with all these leaks? Like, why does stuff keep coming out? Is it because somebody was leaking, or is it because they literally hacked the internet in there? In the actual court filing, it says that data was collected that was non-public. So what does that mean? They hacked it. Like, if my house is not open to the public and somebody just finagles their way in, then you broke into my house. It's not public. I have locks on it. How did you get into my house? It's not like, what's going on? You hacked into it. Now, how did they hack into the White House? That's a pretty secure location, right? Well, you'd be correct when you would assume that. But see, the problem is that the federales were involved here. This is the equivalent to Watergate, or worse, really, because it's not like they had to break in from the outside. You know, Hillary Clinton cited these so-called computer scientists, but and the whole thing was she's trying to say that Russia, they hacked and all this and that. But really, it was the inside job. The federales were involved here because there was a government contract already for internet security in the White House. So this contract was exploited to use it as a way to spy on Trump and anyone around him, allegedly, from what the court filing says. And again, I'll link to all my sources in the description box below so you can read it for yourself. You can see it for yourself. Matter of fact, you can see the whole court filing from the Durham probe. So they spied on him in the White House. They spied on him in Trump Tower and everywhere else to try and get some kind of dirt on the whole Russia thing, because Hillary Clinton wanted to win. And not just Hillary Clinton, but the whole establishment, all the big politicals on the left, sometimes even on the right, they wanted to maintain power. They did not want Trump in there. I think Trump even said it himself. It's like, look, they're not after me. They're after you. I'm just in the way. They can get a regular patsy in there. They don't really care about nothing. You know, just like with Joe Biden. Trump said some pretty spicy things out there when he was the president and also on the campaign trail and afterward, but nothing like what Joe Biden has said. I've never heard Trump use the N-word or hand out free crack pipes or nothing like that. But Biden can do that because he's basically empty suit. He's a patsy. He's just a figurehead. He does whatever they tell him to do. But a guy that leads from the front has to be vilified and just gotten rid of. Okay. And then going back to the whole claims of the 2020 election being tampered with, Trump can't say that because that's somehow an affront to national security and you're emboldening people that want to do harm to the U.S. All this and that, you know, it's an unfounded conspiracy theory. But Hillary Clinton still says that Trump is an illegitimate president because Russia colluded. They cooperated with the Trump campaign to win. They stole the election, all this, that, and the third. Although there's no evidence of that. The whole Mueller probe took 2 years, well, 2 or 3 years, really. like $40 million, a bunch of time and money wasted to find nothing. Zero zilch nada when it relates to any kind of collusion between Trump and the Russians. So she has no evidence, but she's allowed to say it. Why? Because, again, she is a company guy. Basically, she'll do whatever the company tells her to do. That's why. Or she is the company itself. Okay, it's one thing. You could be the establishment yourself, or you could be a pawn of them. I think Joe Biden is probably both. He is establishment. He's also a pawn of the establishment, but Hillary Clinton is the top of the food chain. Now, the question is, will anything happen to these people? I doubt it. There probably won't be any charges. There probably won't be any kind of indictments coming about. And I think the reason is that, again, they are the establishment. It's a different set of rules for them. They could do pretty much whatever they want, essentially, unfortunately. But if you're a regular, normally like myself, then that's not necessarily the case. If you are identified as a quote-unquote right-wing extremist, if you're like a Donald Trump supporter, if you have on the red hat, then it probably won't go well for you. Now, my solution to all this, to all this corruption and nonsense that we see going on right in front of our eyes is you got to stop voting for these people. You got to stop voting for these people. If everybody just said, you know what, we're not going to vote for these people, it's not going to work anymore, and they still win, then at that point, you're like, okay, this ain't going to work. We're going to do something else. Okay, and we're going to cross that bridge when we get to it. But as of right now, people got to understand what's happening. You got to understand that these people are corrupt. They're crazy, and they'll do anything to stay in power. You got to go back to 2020 and see what transpired there. 2016, see what transpired there, because we have evidence now. We have evidence that Trump was spied on for a particular reason, and that's to get him out of the way. These are Hillary Clinton operatives, Hillary Clinton's friends, Hillary Clinton's people, Jake Sullivan, all these people, part of the deep state swamp. This is what Trump was referring to as a close when he's talking about draining the swamp. Now, obviously, it's easier said than done, right? You want to drain the swamp, but is it that simple? Not really. But he's referring to this type of stuff right here, where you have people that are government employees engaging in pure corruption, trying to get a sitting president out of office. But I think I'll leave that right there for now. And what say you? How do you feel about what happened here with the Durham probe, or at least in this bombshell news information? How do you feel about the mainstream media ignoring it, not even talking about it? Like, it's one thing to give it, I guess you would say, it's one thing to validate it, but you're not even covering it. You're not even talking about it at all. I think they're not talking about it because they know it's true. They don't want to highlight how corrupt they are, because really, it's not just Joe Biden, Barack Obama, Hillary Clinton. It's the whole establishment. The permanent government employees, the mainstream media, so-called news outlets like Slate. It's the whole thing. They're all involved with it, all of them. So, of course, they don't want to report on how corrupt they are. So, leave it to guys like myself and many others to give you real information, not just cherry-picked from the mainstream media to feed you narratives and a story and a false reality rather than the truth. But whatever your thoughts are, please let me know in the comments below. And that's all I got to say for this video. If you like what you heard, please comment, rate, share, and subscribe. Peace.